That's the Montauk Monster. Oh my God, first time I see a clear photograph. But look at the surrounding area, it's all reptilian images. That one right there. It's all reptilian. Look. Wow, man. Oh my God. It's all covered with reptilian images. The entire area. Look at that, the eyes. Same thing you see on the moon. All those monsters. Nasty looking monster. Wow. Incredible, my God. Somebody that doesn't know anything about the reptilian would never even see any of it. I mean, I can see it's just the entire area is covered with reptilian shapes. Look at that down here. Look at his eyes right there. Electromagnetic energy from those reptilian son of a bitches. And from you just look at it, just look like a wood, a little forest. Unless you know what they look like, you will never notice anyway. One face look one way and the other at the same time. It's the same thing that's happened in the moon. This face look one way, but look at this face, look the other way. It's two faces in one. So that's what the Montauk Monster look like. An electromagnetic creation from the mind of one of those, the priest Preston Nichols. I think he was sitting on the Montauk chair when he started thinking in his mind about a monster, and they had to destroy practically the power supply to the station because the monster became real and starting destroying everything around them. They couldn't shoot him down, they couldn't kill him. But the only way was to take out the power source from the computer, and that monster froze up in time. It's there. It will be there forever. That's why nobody goes. They don't let no one go to that Montauk Point, the ex-naval station where they were working on the radar that see over the horizon, the SAGE system. That's how they call it. But it became a research laboratory for the German and American scientists that were working on mind control and time travel and all bunch of shit that we can't even imagine. But it's just the rumors are, you know, now these people are speaking up. Al Bielek is dead now, but he told the story a while back.